Meredith Whalen was a BBA at the University of Michigan Business School. 2001, we lost her. Down here is a little pathway. When I follow the little pathway, it leads to what we have here at the Ross School of Business, a memorial bench. To my right is a business school and a tree, a memorial bench, and to the left, we have a trading floor. I've wondered at times if I should say something today or not. And as I thought about this kind of stuff, I thought I'd read something to you that I wrote. I'm gonna read this because I found it kind of hard to talk about this stuff. So I wrote it down and I read it. I couldn't sleep the other night as I kept thinking of 911. In some manner, I was grieving. I was feeling numb. I was reflective. I was mad. I wanted to remember and I wanted to forget. Everyone grieves in some manner or another, and everyone does it at a different pace. I kept tossing and turning. Should I write about what I felt that day? Should I make a YouTube video of how I felt that day? Should I just say nothing? Because it can bring back pain. And there are some who say they're just sick and tired of hearing of this stuff. Yet I realized that I was still grieving, and I had to write something about it. 11 years ago, I met a guy named David Alger. This guy. It's in the Barron's magazine. Barron's, at one point, right there. At the time, the Ross School of Business was the University of Michigan Business School, and the Tawsey Trading Floor hadn't been built yet. I was working on a computer help desk, part of a team, providing an essential role to the faculty and staff at the school. Working along with Professor Richard Sloan, we had created a small windowless trading floor the back of the school. A portfolio management class, we held it. And one of our first guest speakers was David, an alum from Michigan. Alger, he managed billions at Alger Management, and his firm was on the 93rd floor at the World Trade Center. When he walked into the trading floor, students respected him. They listened to him. They were motivated by him, and we were well aware of his passion in the market. He spoke about stocks and the markets, and although students would have fun agreeing and even disagreeing with him, it's the markets. Everyone disagrees with everyone else sometimes, you know. He was respected, though. Unfortunately, we knew what happened 10 years ago. He, along with many others from the University of Michigan and Alger Management, were lost. On 911, I was working the trading floor. We were up in a way up there. We were in a small little cubbyhole. And as CNBC was turned on the TV, I watched as the towers were hit. I remember being in a state of shock. It was hard to believe that what I was seeing was true. It was unfathomable. I would run down the stairs from the trading floor and run into a director. In my shock, I told him what had happened. He too was in shock when I told him. Classes would be canceled that day at the business school, and we were left wondering, what next? Later, when classes resumed, I had heard from professors that it was hard to teach. Nearly everyone knew they knew someone who had died. Myself, I kept thinking of Alger. He was the one that I knew. I knew there were others, but he was the one that I knew. I also kept thinking of a long-lost former friend who was living in New York. And although we didn't speak anymore, I was worried about them as well. As I don't want to hold any bitterness in my life. I was wishing nothing but the best for them. So if something bad had happened to them, it actually would have hurt me as well. Although it's been said many times before, on that day, I think everyone became a New Yorker. Even the Canadian and me, there were Canadians that were lost. I too was a New Yorker. Today, 110,000 people will gather for the largest football game in America. That's why I'm wearing this shirt. Go Blue. People behind me are walking to the football game this evening. The University of Michigan will play against Notre Dame. After 9-1-1, everything changed, even this football game today. Streets that were previously open around the stadium are now closed. People used to bring bottled water into the stadium. Now they need to pay $4 to use water inside the stadium. There's business. Airplanes used to fly over the stadium with banners during the game. Not anymore. The events changed a lot of things. It created business for others. I remember talking to a huge hedge fund man or a huge fund manager about the time period after 9-1-1. He explained that although the events were tragic, New York was still alive. When the markets were opened up, the liquidity in the market was higher than it had been in a while. My sheets are getting wet. As a result, they were able to buy and sell securities that would be normally too illiquid to trade. During a normal day, if they bought and sold something, it would have impacted the market. And so that day was an opportunity to trade hopefully make some money. A few years after 9-1-1, I made my way to Wall Street on a trip with students to various banks. We would walk from bank to bank, and students would visit with each bank and get an idea of where they would like to work at. At some point during that trip, I went on my own to Ground Zero. Just like many before me, I would visit the site. I saw the flowers, the steel cross, the buildings drenched in black construction cloth, and the teddy bears. I saw the world sculpture that had survived the Defiant Church, and the names written on the wall of the souls lost that day. There on the wall, I saw Alger's name. I took a photo of it. There, on the wall, was his name. I was numb once again, and I had to cry. I would make my way up to the Empire State Building. It was a foggy day, and I was the only one at the top. I was free to walk around without any crowds. I was alone, it was foggy, and I couldn't see New York City, but I could hear it. Of the photos that I took that day, apart from that photo I just showed, of Alger's name on the wall, the ones that speak to me the most are two photos I took of viewing binoculars. In one photo, it looks out into the fog. I'm getting wet. This one. It looks out into the fog. The binocular can't see anything. It's as if the binocular looks out to New York and asks, "What's next? Are you there? Are you okay?" In another photo, one binocular looks at the other. This one. And it asks, "Are you okay? I'm looking out for you. We care about each other. We look out for each other." I was numb, I was crying, but even though it was foggy at the top and the future wasn't clear, I could still hear New York City below. New York was alive, it wasn't about to give up. New York and other locations were hit that day, but the city lived, it healed, and all of us are still healing. Hopefully in some way, we can be like those two binoculars, we can look out for each other.